Yashodanandana Bhaja Janaranjana Yamunatiravanachari Yamunatiravanachari Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jayo Radha Gopinath Radha Gopinath Sri Radhe Jayo Sri Gopal Jayo Sri Gopal Jayo Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Jayo Lakshman Hanuman. Jayo Gauranitai, Gauranitai. Gauranitai Jayo Gauranitai Jayo Jayo Prabhupad 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 Prabhupad
Jai Om Vishnupad Paramahamsa Parivrajaka Acharya Ashtotra Shishimat Abhay Charanaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Shaprupad Ki Grantra Shrimad Bhagavatam Ki Samaved Gaura Bhaktivinda Ki Nitaya Gaura Premanande All Guris Assembled Devotees All Guris Assembled Devotees All Guris Assembled Devotees All Guris, All Guris, All Guris Shishi Guru and Shri Gauranga Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om ajnanatimirandhasya jnananjanashalakaya chakshurunmilitam yena tasmai shri gurave namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam tam sajivam Sadvaitam savadutam Parijana sahitam Krishna Chaitanya devam Shri Radha Krishna padan Sahagana lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyasya Kripasindhubhyavacha Patidanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. A very hearty welcome to all those that have come for our Sunday feast program. In this month of October, during the Navaratri time, where there's other types of gatherings that happen. And this is one of our most consistent programs that has been happening, where every Sunday we experience the cooling breezes of the air conditioning, but more than that, the enlightening knowledge and the devotion that Lord Krishna expresses in the Bhagavad Gita and in the Bhagavatam. And many qualified speakers have sat on this very holy seat and delivered amazing lectures. So personally, I don't deserve to be sitting here, but upon the instruction of my authorities and seek the blessings of senior devotees like Vrishabhanu Prabhu to speak something worthwhile. And today we are in the midst of, in the eve of celebrating Dashara on Tuesday. In 2 days, Ravana will be killed or was killed way back in the Treta Yuga. But although Ravana was killed way back, somehow Ravana survives. Even till now. Therefore, there is a saying in Hindi, Ram abhi bhi van mein hai, kyunki Ravan abhi bhi man mein hai. This conditioning, this disease of ego and lust till they are in the heart cannot accept the Lord's position, Lord into our heart. And therefore, Dashara is very significant. After Dashara, in the northern India, Dashara is not that famous. It is Diwali that is famous. Dashara is more famous in south. In the south, South India, just like we have Diwali holidays, all over South India, the holidays, the quarterly exam holidays happen after Dashara. And myself, hailing from Hyderabad, these 10 days were very much look forward to not being in the mission or something, but just to be free. And we can also understand, because Ravana was killed in the south, and so the event was more celebrated in that part of the world. And in Diwali time, Lord Ram returns back to Ayodhya, and Ayodhya is in the north. And so therefore, maybe Diwali is more famous in the north than Dashara. But both these festivals are very important for us to invite the Lord to back to His place, back to Ayodhya, which is supposed to be our heart. We have to first rule out this evil, this devil, this enemy called as Ravana. And till the dirt is removed, it is not a proper place for a guest to be welcomed, or anyone. You don't welcome someone into a very dirty place. Therefore, before the Sunday feast happens, our Sunanda Prabhu and all the devotees, they clean this whole temple hall to just make it ready for all the Sunday feast audience that come and sit. So we clean first. So same way Dashara represents cleaning of the heart, and then Diwali represents inviting the Lord back to Ayodhya. There is a folklore that when Lord Ram was going back to Ayodhya after killing Ravana, there was so much joy everywhere that all the villages, they lighted lamps. For entire 14 years, there was no electricity bill. There was no ghee that was spent, because nobody was lighting any lamps. Without Lord, where is the light in our life? And as Lord Ram was passing, in one particular village, there was no light that was near Ayodhya. There was no light. So Lord Ram was curious that why is that everyone is celebrating? Is there some Ravana still existing there? So he went and inquired. And they said that the glory of Ayodhya, the lights that are in Ayodhya, they are looking more beautiful when we don't put our lights on. So therefore, it is not that we are not happy, but we want to see the joy of the Ayodhya Vasis, and for that we have not put the lamps on. And the Lord comes to this world for various reasons, and He doesn't have to come, but He comes again and again in different ways and forms, just to attract our attention. And there are five reasons why basically the Lord comes, and also it is true for Ram Leela. The first reason why the Lord comes is to show His greatness to all of us. Because currently we only get attracted to someone once His greatness is revealed. Now amongst the audience, imagine if some billionaire is sitting. Already maybe some billionaire is sitting. But we are not aware of His greatness, how big an empire He has. So we may not be so interested. But the moment we are aware of His greatness, then we want to make a relationship with Him. So same way the Lord in different pastimes as Matsya, Kurma, Rama, Krishna, Narasimha, when He comes, one of His purposes is to attract the attention of the conditioned souls, all of us, by revealing His greatness, that He is not like any normal conditioned soul who has just taken another birth. That's why Krishna in the Gita says, Janma karma cha me divyam. That my birth and activities are divya. They are transcendental, they are great. And even as Lord Ram, when He came, He did superhuman activities. He built a bridge across the ocean. He made stones float on water. Still the technology is still not available by the scientists, otherwise this whole beach would have been again on sail. We would not have got cool breezes. So, and if you go to Rameshwaram, even till today, those stones that float on water are existing. And in this way, many pastimes as Rama and Krishna, by His pastimes, when we see, no, I cannot do that. Prabhupada always used to say that during this Navaratri time, everybody, their popular play is to play Dandiya or Garba. And it is kind of an imitation of Krishna's Ras Lila. And usually after freely mixing, there is a lot of Ravana that awakens, lust that awakens, and it is records in almost all the hospitals that the abortion rates go up because of immaturely trying to imitate the Lord's pastimes. But Prabhupada always said that before you can imitate Ras Lila, first you imitate Govardhan Lila. Because Ras Lila was done at the age of 8 and Govardhan Lila was done at the age of 7. Try to lift a mountain. And if you can do that, then you are qualified to do the next activity. So when the Lord's great activities are done, then we are inspired to make a relationship with Him. And not just His activities are great, but also the way He scripts His pastimes, the struggles that He shows in His own, with His own devotees, in His own life, in his descent here, they relate very much with our struggles that we are facing. In Ramayana or in Mahabharata, one of the common things is property dispute between brothers. Vali Sugriva, Ram Bharat. Of course, Ram and Bharat were not fighting, but it was accused that Bharat is trying to get the property. And isn't property dispute one of the biggest things today? And then accusation of the character of the wife or the husband, or this need to prove oneself better than others. So all these struggles, all these challenges are also seen in the Ramayana and Mahabharata, because the human psychology has not changed. The human being still aspires for position in this world and neglects that how his real satisfaction comes from connecting to the Supreme Lord. So therefore, the Lord's pastimes like Ramayana and Bhagavatam, there is so much relevancy to our struggles that we face. And that relevancy brings us more closer to Him. Oh, Lord Ram or Pandavas also faced this kind of accusation. Krishna was faced that accusation that you stole the Samantaka jewel. Or Ram was faced accusation that You are a loose human being. That how can you keep a wife that has not been chaste? And so many difficulties they had to face. Another lesson or purpose for which the Lord comes to do His pastimes is not just to connect to Him, but to develop appreciation of His devotees, to appreciate His devotees. That is not just I am great, but more great is my devotees, that in spite of not having anything, they are willing to do everything for me. Story of Shabari, story of Jatayu. Jatayu lost the battle but won the heart of Lord Ram. And others, they may win the battle. Indrajit, so many times he won the battle, but because he was against the mission of the Lord, he never won the heart of the Lord. And when we see that how much devotees go through trouble just to please, and sometimes even in amongst devotees, one devotee doesn't understand another devotee. Lakshman was not understood, Bharat was not understood, Sita was not understood. And even then, when you are not understood, to be loyal, to be chaste, to service. Usually as soon as accusation comes, you say, itna karne ke baad bhi aisa bol rahe, fayda kya hua karke, kya mila mujhe, what did I get after going through so much trouble? So through the Lord's pastimes, we also develop great appreciation for the devotees of the Lord, each one of them. And then it also implores us to correct our trajectory, that how we can reform our direction in life. Where are we going? Are we following in the footsteps of Ravana, or are we following the footsteps of Vanara? Just a change of letters, Ravana and Vanara. Ra comes before or after, but the whole mentality is different. Hanumanji, he wanted to bring Ram and Sita together, but Ravana, he wanted to separate them. So we correct our trajectory by being inspired by the devotees' lives, that I want to follow in their footsteps. And finally, just hearing about the Lord's pastimes establishes a strong connection. Lord's names, Lord's pastimes, Lord's deity, when we serve them, when we hear them, when we come in contact with them, it's not just, it inspires us to develop a connection, but that itself starts to build a very deep connection with the Lord. And this is the purpose for which the Lord comes, out of His causeless mercy, to give us, all of us, as this acronym says, grace. That without the Lord's intervention, we can never pass out of this material world. Like in college or school, there's always grace marks given. He's just close enough, so usko thoda extra de do. And the three steps in connecting to the Lord, the first is the sambandha gyan, where we connect, being inspired by His example, by His pastimes. Then we correct, which is abhideya. We correct, it's not that we just want to connect now, but we also correct whatever is not proper. And then we also carouse. Carouse is we start to immerse in the Lord's name, in the Lord's service, and that is the fruit that we get, the love of God. And I'm just going to take a small section, especially about Dashara, because we have shorter time today. There is the World Harinam Festival today at Chowpatty, where from all over Bombay, devotees have been invited from all the temples, ISKCON temples. And around 3:30, we are going to start the Harinam. So therefore, we have to end a little early than usual. So this demonic energy, Ravana, as I said, Ravan abhi bhi man mein hai. Ram van mein hai aur Ravan man mein hai. And Ravana, he was not just a unintelligent, just sporadic being. He was very learned. Highly learned, but highly corrupted in his values. Many times we gauge a person just by his clothes. It said one of the saints when he went to UK, London, there was a conference there and he was wearing simple robes. So they told him that you don't look like a gentleman. Gentleman means you have to have a suit and a boot, blazer. And this particular sadhu, he said that in your country, clothes make a gentleman. But in my country, India, it is a character that makes you a gentleman. It is your manners, it is your attitude. So Ravana was highly sophisticated in his technology, in his wealth, but corrupted in his values of not being concerned about others, but always thinking about how the world or how everyone else can gratify him. And there is a trouble with this, that when we try to be selfish, then we don't experience peace, we don't experience satisfaction. Today in the world, depression is high. They say that one of the largest rates of depression in the world is India, last year. And one of the reasons for depression, one of the main reasons, is self-obsessed or self-absorbed. Especially today in digital age with social media, your profiles mean everything to you. Facebook or Instagram, and people keep on posting selfies and this and that, and they keep seeing how much am I valued by the number of likes you get. Therefore, one philosopher, he said that this is the first generation that has documented their life to a great degree without achieving much in their life. Previous ages, documentation used to happen after achieving something extraordinary. Then, okay, there was an effort to document. But now, everything is documented, but without achieving actually much. So, Ravana is also an example that how when we don't focus on trying to cleanse and purify the inner world, our inner being, and just try to acquire everything, positions and achievements, but don't take care that how do you handle your desires. Happiness is an equation, and this equation is resources divided by desires. Most people only focus on increasing their desires, increasing their resources. The more resources you have, the more happy you will be. Which is true, but if the desires are not in control, if the desires are also increasing more than the resources, then you will always be unhappy. But even if you have less resources, but if your desires are small, less, then your happiness quotient will be high. Therefore, they say, right, HRD, the human resource development, but real HRD is H, happiness is equal to R by D. And Ravana represents that person who had no control on his denominator. That, okay, some desire comes, I should fulfill this. And for this, he need mind, okay, if I have to follow the Vedic path, he was an expert Brahmana, knowing all the Vedic methods and all the Vedas. So therefore they say that Ravana's 10 heads also represent the knowledge of the 4 Vedas and the 6 darshans, that these 6 kinds of understandings of the Vedas that are there. And in spite of all that, still he didn't know what is the goal of the Vedas. As Krishna says, that from all the Vedas, sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto matta smitir jnanam apohanam cha vedesya sarvair ahameva vedyo vedanta kritibir ahameva. That from all the Vedas knowledge, understanding, it is to love and serve the Supreme Lord. But you follow the rituals, but you don't reach the goal. So prosperous he was, but also dissatisfied. And in today's session, we're just going to take few stories of Ramayana, especially about Ravana, because all these 10 heads represent 10 anarthas or 10 sins that we all have. It is a common disease. It is not a disease, it is an epidemic. And some of you may actually burn an effigy of Ravana, but whether you burn physically or not, by taking the name of the Lord, by chanting the holy names, our goal is to destroy these 10 anarthas, these 10 sins that are plaguing us, and because of which we are not able to experience any contentment or any kind of happiness. So 10 sins to overcome from Rama, from Ravana's example. The first head of Ravana, or one of the mentalities of Ravana, was his inhuman behavior or his cruelty. He was not a kind-hearted being that cared for others' well-being. He didn't mind to trouble anyone. It is said that Ravana's was completely a non-vegetarian. He was drinking blood and wine all the time. When Hanumanji goes to Lanka, he sees that all over the palace, pibaswa, one of the qualities of Lanka is that pibaswa, that everyone was drunk. So amanavata or cruelty is one of the symptoms of Ravana, mentalities of Ravana. In fact, the name Ravana means one who makes others cry. Jo dusron ko rulata hai. And who all did he make cry? All the devatas were in fear of him. It is said that he made all the devatas to be his maid servants. Ghar mein sab कोई झाड़ू मार रहा था, सब देवता, somebody was cleaning the toilet, somebody was cutting the vegetables. So Ravana represents this first quality of cruelty. And in our life, that mainly comes out in the form of meat eating, that just for gratification of our tongue, we kill animals, we stop somebody else's life, we take away somebody else's right to live, just because I want to have that tasty experience. And as George Bernard Shaw said, that how can you have peace in this world when you make your stomachs into graveyards? Pet ko jab smashan bhumi banayenge, to shanti kaise ho sakta hai? And we have to work on this quality, that not to be cruel. And sometimes it is not cruelty towards animals, it is cruelty or insensitivity towards others. We just don't care how others feel when we speak. We're very blunt in our speech or harsh. So that has to be also purified. And how do we overcome this sin? As Ramayana very graphically shows, no one can kill Ravana except Lord Ram. And same way, nothing else can purify this deep-rooted sins except the name of Lord Ram, name of Lord Krishna. It is only the holy name. It is only connection to the Supreme Lord directly that we can remove this. When Hanumanji came to check whether Sita is in Lanka, when he saw Sita Devi, immediately offered her that I will take you across the ocean. I flew and only the pilot was there, the whole flight was empty. So when we are going back, you can come on my back. It will only take few moments for me to take you out of this trouble. But Sita, one of the reasons she gives is that I will be out of trouble for sure if I take your help. But what about all the other ladies that Ravana has kidnapped? Who will rescue them? So Sita, although she was herself in a troubled situation, she was thinking about others' troubles. This is the nature of a devotee. Whereas one who is not a devotee, he only thinks of his own pleasures. And the second mentality or sin that Ravana represents is lust, kama, which is the most prominent feature of Ravana. All this, when Jai Vijay came in three times in different in the Satyayuga as Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu, in Treta Yuga as Ravana and Kumbhakarna, and in Dwapar Yuga as Shishupal and Dantavakra. So we have the six anarthas, and out of that, Hiranyaksha represents greed and Ravana represents lust. Kumbhakarna represents indolence or laziness, that just eat and sleep, and sleep more, eat whenever there is gaps in between your sleep. Usually Sundays becomes like Kumbhakarna's days, where we just want to sleep. Of course, not those devotees that have come, but in general. So this lust, kama, also very strong in all of us. Very difficult to overcome this. Somehow or other, it keeps coming. And lust has two natures. One is a general, generic, another is specific. Generic is where there is a general desire to enjoy anything and everything. Whomever you see, whatever you just. But this general lust many times becomes very specific. That now I am not attracted to anyone and everyone, but only to her or him. This is a more acute stage of lust. And at this stage, it is very difficult to control it. At this stage, when you are doing sadhana, when you are chanting the holy names, if you are specifically diseased in different situations, it becomes even a bigger challenge. Therefore, we always should be careful that our anarthas don't land on some particular objects. Because once they land, they glue so much, it appears as if that person who became lusty after that lady or that boy, he became detached from everything else. Bolta na baki sab kuch suna suna lag raha hai tumhare bina mujhe. So that is not renunciation, that is deep rooted lust. Ravana, when he became lusty after Sita, although he had so many other ladies in his palace, he had Devakanyas, he had Rishikanyas, he had Rajakanyas. Ravana was like a universal shoplifter. Jo kuch bhi kahin pe acha laga, utha ke jeb mein dal liya. Paying the price, who cares? But when he got attracted to Sita, Mandodari was saying, there are so many others. No, I don't, apparently detached, apparently no lust about anyone else, because lust becomes very deep rooted and it appears that if I just get this, then I'll be happy. Then I'll not have. But the disease of lust, the nature is that once one desire is fulfilled, then only it proposes next desire. Mind is like that. Mind, at a time, it doesn't propose 10 things. It only proposes you, if you want to keep me happy, peaceful, मुझे ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं चाहिए. जैसे कभी कभी बोलते ना, बेटा बस तुम इंजीनियरिंग कर ले या शादी कर ले या अमेरिका चला जा, बस इतना कर ले. But after that, there is a next step. Oh, you have done this, but if you are not doing this, then what is the use? You should do this now. So say, that's how the mind, the lust tricks. And there is a story in Ramayana that Mandodari once was asking Ravana, that you can change your form. To kidnap Sita, you became a sadhu and went to bring Sita. Why don't you change your form to Ram and go to Sita, and then Sita will agree to be with you. You can enjoy with her. And Ravana said, don't you think this plan didn't come to me? It came to me. But there is a trouble with this plan that I have. Because when I have to change to some form, then I have to meditate on that form. Say when I had to become a sadhu, even Krishna says in the Gita that what you think of, that's what you become. So for us it happens at death, but for the yogis, for those who are powerful beings, they just think any time and they can form into that being. So Ravana said, if I have to become like Lord Ram, then I have to think of Lord Ram. And Mandodari said, so can't you think of Lord Ram? So I can think. But as soon as I start meditating on Lord Ram, my desire to enjoy Sita is going away. My lust is going away. I am seeing Sita as mother. Sita mujhe maa jaisi lag rahi hai, jaisi Bhagwan Ram pe main dhyan kar raha hun. And this is also the only way how we can purify our lust by putting our mind at the lotus feet of Lord Ram and Lord Krishna. The more the mind meditates on the names and pastimes of the Lord, the more the lust, the disease of lust will dissipate. And the more we just try to not chant or not take shelter of the holy names, because in this day and age, the best way by which the Lord's can be present in our lives, in our mind, is through chanting. Through chanting, the name of the Lord is not different than the Lord. And when we chant the names of the Lord, slowly, slowly the desire to selfishly enjoy goes down, and slowly, slowly the desire to help others, serve others, serve the Lord starts to awaken. So, if you want to overcome lust, again, it is to take shelter of the name of Lord Ram. The third head of Ravana represents ego, ahankar. Krishna says in the Gita that one who is influenced by ahankar, kartaham iti manyate, ahankara vimudatma, that I am the doer, it is me who is the possessor or the owner of everything that I have. And Ravana, such a egoistic person, that although he stole everything else, but he was not thinking this is stolen property. He was thinking this is my property because I have rightfully stolen. I have used my power. The golden city that Ravana has was Kubera's. Kubera had constructed that. And it was in the Himalayan mountains because devatas stay there in the top of Gandhamadana mountain. And then Ravana saw, he said, I need this house. He didn't ask who is the architect, where can I get this house made. He just said, I just want this house. And he stole it. And then he made such a protection that nobody else can now enter my city. And he established guards and Lankini. And like some countries, heavy immigration or entry difficulties. Nobody has allowed there without proper approvals. So Ravana, everything was taken from all others, but still, once he had it, nobody else should have this. This is mine. I am the rightful owner of this. But factually, he got everything from the benedictions that Lord Shiva, whom he used to worship, gave. But that was not his understanding or mentality, that everything belongs to Lord Shiva. He thought, I am the greatest. I am the one who is possessing. And this ahankar, how will it go away? And this is a deep-rooted, again, disease for wanting acceptance or recognition. That we only are recognized or accepted in this world when we have something. Otherwise, we are usually abused or made fun of. That was also one of the reasons why Manthara didn't want her post to be the favorite queen's favorite maid servant to be gone away, because she had a hunchback. And before she got this very powerful position as a favorite maid servant of Kaiki, people in general used to make fun of her. But after she got this powerful position, she became favorite of Queen Kaiki, then nobody dared to make fun of her. So she feared that if I lose that post, then I'll again be ridiculed. I'll again be seen as an outcast, somebody who doesn't belong here. But when we connect to the Supreme Lord and understand how much He loves and accepts each and every living being, we don't need to artificially prove ourselves through our ahankar that we are something. Ahalya was accepted by the Lord. Although she had committed sin, but because she was repenting, she was accepted by the Lord. But those who act out of this ahankar, that I am the one who is the doer, same thing Wali. Wali also didn't accept that all my powers don't belong to me, but they are the benedictions, they are the grace of someone else, and right now I am having it. Whether it be beauty, whether it be knowledge, we only have it for a short while. And then it is passed down to someone else. So therefore, ahankar will also be purified. When we understand that my real position is a very safe position at the lotus feet of the Lord, being His servant. Being the servant of the Lord is the safest position, because Lord's feet are the best place where there is no fear. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada's name is also Abhay Charan. Because when you take shelter of the Lord's lotus feet, then you experience real fearlessness. But when there is not that shelter, then there is so much fear and anxiety. Prabhupada used to give this example. In a shopping mall, a child is very free till she is holding the finger of his mother. Because she knows, I am taken care. I don't have to worry. But till this is gone, this connection is gone, then she becomes very scared, very fearful. She starts to cry. Where is my mother, or who will take care of me now? So we don't have to prove or show ourselves as something great when we understand that my Lord will take care of me, and he is so glorious, He makes His devotees more famous than Him. In the Mahabharata war, Arjuna became the hero. In the Lanka war, Hanumanji became the hero. Hanumanji took a flight from Rameshwaram to Lanka. He could fly. And Ram, it's not that he cannot fly, but he chose to walk. And almost every home has this photo of Hanumanji carrying the Sanjeevani. So Lord is so selfless, or so much wanting to give His devotees fame, and the devotees are so selfless, they want to give the Lord all the fame. Therefore, the name of mother, Lord Krishna's mother, is Yashoda. Yasha means fame, and Da means one who gives. So the devotee wants to make the Lord famous, the Lord wants to make the devotee famous. So therefore, when we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, when we experience that soothing shelter, and so many times whenever there is great insecurity or anxiety, just become calm. Nowadays there is these t-shirts, be calm and do this. So be quiet and just chant Hare Krishna. Just take shelter of the Lord. Intensely take His shelter. And immediately you will feel there is no need for any external validation for me to feel safe or secure. So that is, Ravana also represents ego, ahankar, wanting to guard. The fourth head of Ravana represents anyai, injustice. It's not that he was a very just. Again, same thing. He was stealing others' property and claiming to be his own. And during the Lanka's war, every day he used to drown all the soldiers, Rakshas soldiers that were killed in the battle, in the ocean. So that everybody else will feel that not many have died. Sometimes it happens that countries don't declare how many were killed in their side. They say nobody was killed, or no aircraft was broken. So Ravana, he wanted to publish in the newspaper, Sri Lanka Times, that yesterday nobody was killed because no dead bodies were found. Why no dead bodies were found? Because he drowned all of them in the night, not caring that they are his own people. Whereas Lord Ram, he kept all of his soldiers, all the vanaras who were died, and at the end of it, he revived all of them. Not even one soldier that gave up their life died. Krishna gave back them their life. So therefore, when we are serving the Lord, there is no anxiety that will there be injustice. But this tendency is there not to be just. And by taking again the shelter of the Lord, by understanding His magnanimity, His greatness, we'll overcome this mentality of for our benefit to cause harm to others or be unjust to others. Fifth is krodha, anger. Krishna says in the Gita that when lust is unfulfilled, then it manifests as anger. And Ravana, of course, he died is with lust being unfulfilled. Therefore, in next life, he was born as Shishupal. And Shishupal represents krodha, anger. And how angry he was. From the time of his birth, he was angry at Krishna. Because in the last life, he didn't allow his lust to be fulfilled. And again, as Shishupal, he again tried to marry Sita's next incarnation, Rukmini. And last time, Ravana kidnapped. So this time, he made a proper deal. Shadi se pehle hi pahunch gaya. Last time, Sita ka shadi hone ke baad pahunch gaya tha. So this time, he proposed through Rukmini and the father of Rukmini? Bhishmaka. That I want to marry Rukmini. So full proposal, proper proposal. But again, Krishna did tit for tat. Krishna kidnapped this time Rukmini. Ravana kidnapped Sita. So Krishna used same technique that Ravana used to foil the plan of Ravana as Shishupal. And it said when Shishupal saw Krishna kidnapping Rukmini, he just broke down there. Because this is his second time, second incarnation, again the plan failed. And it was so demoralized. And many times, anger has two faces. If anger is not expressed, it internally appears as frustration or depression. And when anger is expressed, somebody else becomes hurt. When anger is not expressed, you hurt yourself. But anger is the result of lust being unfulfilled. And Ravana, of course, he also represents that. The next thing that Ravana's 10 heads, 10 sins that he represents is moha, attachment. And this attachment towards Sita developed in Ravana through the agency of Surpanaka. Surpanaka came and she glorified Mother Sita. Sita is so beautiful, she is the best. She deserves you as her husband and this and that. All these are not worthy for you. And the more he heard about Sita, the more he got attracted and attached to wanting to have Sita. This desire developed. And same is true with our developing attachment to the Supreme Lord, Krishna, is hearing. The more we hear and chant the Lord's holy names, the more our attachment and attraction towards the Lord develops. And the more our attraction to the Lord, attachment develops, the more the moha in this world goes down. Otherwise, the attachments in this world are so difficult, they stick to us so strongly that it is very difficult for us to remove our attachments. there is a when you have a bandage, it sticks, especially in those places where there is hair. Once it sticks, you know how difficult it is to remove. Bandage becomes very difficult to remove. And there are some lotions that are available. When you apply them, then it becomes very easy to remove those bandages. Same way the bondage or the attachment that happens in this world, when we apply the holy name of the Lord on our hearts, then our heart's attachments reduce. Otherwise, the nature of attachments is they become more and more stronger. The seventh anartha or sin that Ravana's heads represent is swartha, selfishness. Of course, there are many pastimes in the Ramayana, and many of the stories that we shared already also show how selfish he was. That just for his glory, his enjoyment, he was creating so much trouble for the entire universe. And everyone was praying, when will Ravana die? And therefore all the devatas, they go up to pray to Lord Vishnu, please help us. And another symptom of selfishness, swardha, is you don't respect the sacrifices that others have done for you. You are only conscious of what you have done for others, if you have done anything for others. But when we start to take shelter of the holy names and start practicing bhakti, then we start appreciating how much other devotees are doing for you. You start developing gratitude. And one story comes in Ramayana about Mother Sita. After Mother Sita and everybody came back to Ayodhya, when there was Pattabhishek and the coronation was happening, Sita Devi was crying during the coronation ceremony. So Lord Ram asked her, why are you crying? And she said that during this celebration, when these colors are being thrown in the air, we call it gulal, when this color is being thrown in the air, this reminded me of the blood of Jatayu that splashed out when Ravana cut his wings. And Jatayu sacrificed his life for my sake. So in times of great joy, she didn't forget all the sacrifices that someone else did so that you are in this position. But when we are selfish, then we often don't value those. Or there is just one sentence about that and 10 sentences about what I did. So that is another thing that we have to overcome. And again, selfishness is overcome, swartha, when we understand the real benefit, interest of the soul is in connecting to Krishna. That's what Prahlad Maharaj says, that the real benefit of any human being is when he serves the Supreme Lord. Because the Supreme Lord, we are all made in his image. We are all his tiny part and parcels. And he gives his example that when you look at your image in the mirror, you don't try to decorate the reflection. You try to decorate the real person. And when you decorate the real person, the reflection is already decorated. Same way, when we serve the Supreme Lord, when we please the Supreme Lord, yasmin tuste jagat tuste, that when he is pleased, then every living being is pleased. And one of the best ways to please the Supreme Lord and remove our selfishness again is to loudly chant the holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So swardha is also removed, like the devotees that are in Here in International Society for Krishna Consciousness, you will hear so many stories of devotees that have so much wealth, but for the sake of like how the temple of Vedic planetarium is being built in Mayapur, Ambarish Prabhu, the descendant of Ford heritage, he has given half of the money, $250 million, to build the temple, and rest of the money is being raised. And devotees become, their selfishness is removed, because now they experience a much greater vishaya vinivartante niraharasya dehina, because they experience a higher taste. The eighth is greed, loba. Loba, this greed to wanting to have more and more. Prabhupada explains that Ravana had so much greed to get gold that whatever gold was available anywhere on the planet, he came and made Lanka. But although he made Lanka, he could not enjoy there. Later, Vibhishan became the king. And same with Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu was so greedy, he conquered the whole universe. But a selfless devotee like Prahlad became the king. That's what Prabhupada, once he was going in a garden in Japan, and said, "These gardens are so beautiful. Who made them?" He said, "The Japanese people made them so that they can enjoy them." But Prabhupada said, "But they are all empty. Where are they?" "Oh, they are all working hard in their jobs so that they can maintain them." Then Prabhupada said, "Okay, let them work hard, we will enjoy." So factually, people are working hard to build so many buildings and this and that, but if you see their lives, hardly they are enjoying. But devotees, we get to actually relish life, because there is no selfishness. The ninth thing is jealousy, matsara, that why should he have, I should get everything. And this envy or jealousy is also very, very deep rooted. And again, in this story, that one of the reasons this Surpanakha was his sister, and Surpanakha came and he told about the glory of the beauties of Mother Sita, and also told how Ram is also very powerful. Karadushan in sabko mar diya. Because first she didn't complain to Ravana. She went to branch office, local office in Nasik only, Karadushan. Wahan pe kaam nahi hua to fir headless office ko gayi. 10 heads. And so Surpanakha, it seems to be that she wanted to take revenge, but there is another story that Surpanakha's husband was killed by Ravana because he was not hearing, he was trying to compete with the position of Ravana. And as soon as he saw somebody was competing, he killed him, his own sister's husband. And therefore Surpanakha had that, somehow I want to trouble him. And for that reason, she prompted him towards Lord Ram, because Lord Ram is the only match by which Ravana can be subdued. Of course, this doesn't come in the Valmiki Ramayana, but this is another addition. That how Ravana, if somebody competes, then remove the competition. Kill them. And the last that Ravana represents is pride, Mada. So many people went and told Ravana, "Chhod do Sita ko. We have so many, nahi." But when there is pride, when there is this feeling of greatness about what you have, then that pride brings your fall down. And same with the story of Ravana, that his so much pride on his powers, on his armies, ultimately became his downfall. So we pray to the Supreme Lord Krishna, Lord Ram, that you, in this day and age, you have kindly come in the name of, in your holy names, And by taking your holy names and by sincerely praying to you, may all these 10 sins be purified from my heart. And that is a prayer with which we approach and celebrate Dashara. And there is a nice poem, shloka in the Rama Raksha Stotra about the power of chanting of the holy names of the Lord. The last verse we'll take, Bharjanam Bhava Bijana, that when we chant the holy names of the Lord, then the material, the cause of birth and death, the bija of bhava is bharjan. It's a bhurji, paneer bhurji. So, apna jo bhautik samsar mein jo rehne ka jo seed hai, uska bhurji ban jata hai. It is burnt. And once a seed is burnt, it doesn't take root. Arjanam sukha sampada, you will earn real wealth and real happiness. Otherwise, sukha aur sampada dushman hai. Ya to sukha rahega ya sampada rahega. But when you chant the holy names of the Lord, then both are. And then tarjanam yamadutanam, then yamadutas run away. Rama rameti garjanam. When you loudly chant the holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And this will benefit us and also benefit anyone else that hears the holy names of the Lord. And therefore, for this purpose, Srila Prabhupada wanted the devotees following in the footsteps of Lord Chaitanya to go out in the streets and chant loudly the holy names, the Nagar Sankirtan, one of the best ways to access the Lord Chaitanya's mercy. And a kind request to all the audience that after you have your nice Sunday feast prasad, please don't go back to your homes. Extend your stay in the temple for 2-3 more hours and join us as we go towards the beach, Marine Lines Beach, not just like a visitor, but as a helping all so many people that are suffering with these 10 sins or anarthas, diseases, overcome by them hearing the holy names. So the more we have devotees, the louder the holy name will reverberate. So with that request, I will stop. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki. Now there will be kirtan, and after kirtan there will be prasadam.